you can definitely drive something with this. The rotary engine runs on two bearings that are on the other side of this shaft, and it has six magnets that turn past these holes. I'm going to try to make a generator that will fit on this shaft. It's just an idea that I had that might work. And I've cut some mild steel rods that will sit in here, and it will interact with the magnets on this engine. Every time a magnet passes in front of that rod, it should generate a little pulse. I then made a spool on the 3D printer that fits on this rod. And there will be six of these to interact with the six magnets. Then we need a way to hold those spools in place. So I made this base. And then these will go in here. Now with six of these in place, and I have not tightened this down yet, you can see this jumps around quite a bit by the interaction with the magnets. So there will be a nut and a washer. And reach in here with a wrench and tighten that. And once that's tight, this won't jump back and forth anymore. And it's just a matter of indexing this so it's right in the center of those holes. Then there's an external support ring that goes on the back here. There are six magnets in this engine, and each magnet passes one of these spools six times per revolution. One revolution of the engine will produce 36 pulses. I have this set up to where the iron rods are running just as close to the magnets as I can get them without hitting any of the magnets. I test ran this just like this without any coils on here yet, and this will start and run in this configuration. It remains to be seen if after a load is placed on these coils if it will still run. What I'm waiting on now is the wire so I can wind these spools, and a little counting gadget that will allow me to count the turns on each spool very accurately. I would like to make each spool as identical to each other as possible.